हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी डिस्कस द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ वीडियो ऑन बिजनेस स्टडीज क्लास 12th बोर्ड्स प्रिपरेशन। प्लीज डू सब्सक्राइब टू माय चैनल कॉमर्स एंड इन्वेस्टमेंट्स। चैप्टर 11 मार्केटिंग मैनेजमेंट। दिस इज द लेंथीएस्ट चैप्टर ऑफ द सिलेबस एंड मेनी स्मॉल पॉइंट्स बेस्ड क्वेश्चंस आर एक्सपेक्टेड फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर। प्रिपेयर इट वेरी केयरफुली। Marketing management means the functions of management, that is organizing, planning, directing, controlling, done with reference to marketing, that is exchange of goods and services for money. The concepts of marketing management means market means where buyers and sellers meet. Marketing consists of those activities that satisfied needs and wants of customer and you are able to do it better than your competitor. Marketer means any person or organization that provides goods and services to satisfied need of customers. Process of marketing management, selection of target market. First you select what is your target market, then you create demand for the product, and then you offer superior value. It's only when you offer superior value, buyer is going to buy your product. Now prepare this very well. How marketing concept and philosophies have changed over time. Earlier it was production concept. In economics we said supply creates its own demand in traditional theory. Then you had product concept. If you have good product, only then it will sell. Then sell in concept. Besides good product, you need good selling skills also. Then marketing concept means identifying needs of customer and satisfying them. And then the social marketing. Because a business works in a society, it has to care about the society also. The various functions of marketing: gathering and analyzing market information, market planning, then product designing, standardization and grading is very important, packaging, labeling, branding, customer support services, proper pricing, promotion, distribution, transportation, storage and warehousing. Prepare these 12 points very well. Prepare 2 to 3 lines on each of these points. Then marketing mix: product mix, price mix, place mix, promotion mix. Product means, mix means you have to create a product that offers a better value. Then you have to properly brand it. It can be name, sign, proper brand name, mark, then trademark. Go through advantages of branding. It helps in product differentiation, helps in advertising, display. Then you can do better pricing if you have a strong brand. Then ease in introduction of new product. Companies which have a strong brand, they can easily introduce new product in a better way, like you have Hero MotoCorp. Then advantages of branding to customer. It helps in product identification, ensures quality. There is a status symbol attached with certain brand. Characteristics of good brand: it should be simple and easily pronounceable. Supposing if I give you a brand which has 23 words, some German name, you won't be able to pronounce. How can you remember it? It should be suggestive, that is, it should give some idea about the product itself. It should be distinguished from other brands. It should be adaptable. It should be versatile. Legal protection is very important. And staying power. Brand should be durable in the market. Then you have packaging. It is designing and producing the container in which product has to be carried. You have primary package, then secondary package where you keep many small packets. Then transportation packet, where you keep many secondary packages. For example, chocolate wrapper is primary packet, then a carton of 150 chocolates is secondary package, and big carton where chocolates are transported in a truck, these are transportation package. Importance of packaging. Health sanitation is rising. Then now you have self-service outlets and shopping malls. Your packaging should be such it is well displayed. It gives innovation opportunities. Product is easily differentiated. Functions of packaging means product can be easily identified. It is protected. It facilitates use of product easily. It helps in product promotion. Labeling. It is attached to the product. It describes the product. It identifies the product or brand. It will help in grading of the product. It promotes the product. It provides information required by law. Pricing is very important. Many a times good products don't do well because they are not properly priced. You have to look at your cost. because it's only you earn profit only when you sell above the cost. Then demand for product. If a product is inelastic in demand, you have better pricing power. Whereas elasticity is high, your pricing power is pretty limited. Then competition in the market, government and legal regulation. In sectors like pharmaceutical, government cannot allow you to freely charge anything from buyer. Pricing objective, whether you want to just milk away the profit or you want leadership. Then marketing method. You have small channel, long channel, distribution network. It also decides your cost and ultimately pricing. Place of physical distribution means how your product is going to be distributed to end user, that is buyer. Then important decision relating to place is channels of distribution, small channel, big channel, physical movement, what types of good are you selling. Then channels means intermediaries or middlemen who help in selling of goods and services. Types of channel, direct selling means where producers are directly selling to customer like Bata. In direct channel, you are using middlemen like one level, two level, wholesaler, retailer, three level, C&F agent, wholesaler, retailer. Then factors determining choice of channel. Which channel you are using, it depends on various factors like product, it is perishable or not. Company has own channel, company has funds, competitors, market factors, environment factor. All these should be prepared very well. Physical movement of goods, order processing, then transportation, warehousing and inventory control. This ensures timely delivery of goods to consumer. Promotion, all such activities that inform customer about the product of the company, which is promotion mix, advertising, personal selling, sales promotion, public relation. Advertising it paid form, where you pay to media and you show your ad on the TV. From ad, you can easily identify who is the producer. It is paid, impersonal, you can identify sponsor. It has mass reach. Then enhancing with customer satisfaction and confidence. Express, you can easily express, it's an economy. Because if you give an ad on say YouTube or Google or internet on Facebook, you can reach many people with very low cost. Then object of advertising, objections of advertising, that is drawbacks. It adds to cost, yes, it is costly. Then it undermines social values. Many of the advertisements are such which make compromises with the social values and people don't like them. At times, many ads confuse the buyer. Then it encourages sale of inferior products. Just by through advertising, many of the inferior products are being sold. Some advertisements are really very bad in taste. Personal selling means directly contacting the customer and delivering goods to him, pursuing him to buy the goods and telling about the goods and concluding the sale. But for a good salesman, you need certain qualities. Physical quality, he should be well looking, smart guy, he should have very good knowledge. Mental attribute, presence of mind, he should be very good. Vocational, that is speaking skill, should be very good. Courtesy, he should be tactful, he should have very good self-confidence, he should be enthusiastic, he must be honest, persistent, and he must have very good communication skills. Sales promotion means giving short-term incentive to boost sales, like discount, giving a free product with one of the product. Say if you are buying a big TV, you are getting a small mobile free. Sales promotion means you give a rebate, cash rebate, discount, refunds, product combination. Then gift, draws, lucky draws, usable benefits, finance at 0%, sampling, contest, etc. Please prepare difference between rebate, discounts and refunds. I am not telling you here, you have to do it by yourself. Public relation means where a public is, company is maintaining a public relation employee department where they are regularly interacting with public and making a good rapport or image of the organization in the public. Press relation, product publicity, then corporate communication, lobbying, counseling. All these are very important part of public relation. Now we move to next chapter. From this chapter, expect value-based questions. Consumer protection is basically providing protection to consumers against false, fake, unscrupulous goods, unfair trade practices, etc. it is very important from point of view of company because their image depends on it, important from point of view of customer because most of the time consumers are ignorant, they are unorganized, then there is widespread exploitation of consumer, especially in a country like India. Business point of view, long-term interest of business, it's in long-term interest of business to have good consumer protection. Business uses society's resources, so it must be accountable. There is social responsibility, moral justification, and a business, if they want to avoid government interference, then they must be very much aware of consumer rights. Consumer Protection Act 1986, please prepare it very well. It has given certain rights to consumer. It provides safeguard against any exploitation. It has provided three-tier redressal mechanism and remedy to consumer. Consumer has been given certain rights, right to safety, right to be informed, right to choose, right to be heard, right to seek redressal, right to consumer education. Here, you get a story and then question is, which type of right is being asked? So prepare it very well. Consumer responsibility. If a consumer wants protection, he must have certain responsibility also. He should have knowledge about the market, must have be quality conscious. He should use product very safely. Then before using a product, read the instructions carefully. And you should insist on cash memo. If you are not taking bills cash memo, that means you are not paying tax. You cannot get any consumer protection from the government. Consumer must be honest. He must find the complaint in proper format with proper organization. He must save the environment. Complaint can be followed by filed by any consumer, any registered consumer association, central state government. Then on behalf of consumer also, case can be filed, legal hire or representative can file a complaint. If a consumer is deceased, that means consumer dies while using a product. Complaint can be made against unfair and restrictive trade practice, defective product, deficient services, service promised and service given differ, excess prices, hazardous good, hazardous services. There are three-tier agencies, prepare very well, district forum, state commission, national commission. Who can be chairman, how many members can be there, what is the amount, what is the procedure for filing case with district forum, what is the procedure for filing case with the state forum, then procedure for filing case with national forum. And if you are not satisfied with national forum, how can you go to the courts? Then role of consumer organization and non-government organization, that is NGO, in protecting customer. Prepare it very well. And also AgMark, then ISI mark, wool mark, hallmark for gold, etc. Many a times questions do come from these. So this is very important chapter, especially district, state, national level authority and Consumer Protection Act. With this, I conclude the briefs on your business studies. Still, if you have any problem, you can freely contact me. My number is 97192-83244. I am Saurabh Kumar Gupta, Accounts, Economics and BST teacher. Take care. All the best.